Before you begin the research process, let's take a few minutes to learn about it. We're going to identify components of the research process, discuss the difference between discovery and information seeking tools, and identify ways that you can expand and narrow a research topic that you're considering writing about. Like the writing process, the research process is a complex one with distinct steps. Identifying and selecting a manageable topic, creating a research question, setting up a search plan, matching your questions and search terms to library resources, and of course, citing your sources appropriately. In this video, we're concerning ourselves mainly with the first and second parts of this process. Despite the fact that this process seems like a straight line, it really isn't. What happens is fairly recursive. In other words, you may begin with a topic, create a research question, and later decide, after searching the literature, to reformulate both the topic and the question once you've learned more about what you're researching. You could say that the research process features two major phases of information gathering. The first phase can be called the discovery phase. Collecting background information on a topic from sources like encyclopedias, handbooks, and general discovery tools like USF's Quick Search or Google Scholar, this gives you an overview and lets you see how a topic is being discussed generally in the literature, which will then help you narrow it down and manage it better. The next phase, the information seeking phase, is a more focused and directed process. You have your manageable research topic, and you're ready to find exactly the right sources of information for the work you'll do on your research project. This is where specialized databases like Education Source can really come in handy. So how can you tell if your topic is too broad? If you find too much information about a topic, or it seems too big to cover in an 8 to 10 page paper, it may be too broad. You shouldn't have to wade through thousands of search results. On the other hand, how can you tell if a topic is too narrow? If there are few to no resources available about the topic, it's too narrow. If a topic can be discussed in detail, in fewer pages than your assignment calls for, your topic is too narrow. Here are some ways that one could narrow down a topic that's too broad: by time period, location, population, or viewpoint. Also remember to start early and seek help if you need it.